Hello everyone! In this video you can watch me make a geodecosis again, and this time an experiment with colorful transparent powder pigments from Color Art. I want to see if I can create some nice flowers again using the flower technique with these powder pigments. So for the new people to my channel that like experiments like this one or tutorials of acrylics, mixed media and a lot more, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss anything. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to use only transparent powder pigments or tints from Color Art, and the first color is the transparent tint Viola. And you can't mix these pigments directly into your resin. First you need to dissolve them in a little bit of alcohol, not too much, and then that mixture you add to your resin. If you don't do that, then you get all lumps in your resin, so that's not nice. So only a few drops of alcohol and then into your resin. The next color is the transparent tint Crepe Jelly next to the Viola. I think these two colors look very nice together. And again, I'm using the Dipon Epoxyplast 100P. It's from the German company. It's a very thin resin. So again, I waited almost to the end of the working time, so it gets thicker and much easier to pour, and also the colors will not blend too much together. A little bit of blending I like, but not too much. And the next color is also a transparent tint from Color Art, and this is the Hot Lips. Very nice color, very bright. And the mold I'm using is again from the Dutch company Molds and Shapes. I will add the link to their Facebook page, because you can only order it through their Facebook page, in the description box below this video. And for the people outside of Europe, there is not a buy button on their Facebook page. So you need to send them a message if you are interested in this mold. And this mold is great. More of the Viola color. Yeah, and I want to see if I can create a nice flower with the flower technique. And yeah, because of the density of these pigments or the colors, I'm not sure if it's going to work, because the white that I'm going to add on top needs to sink through the color to reach the bottom. So yeah, we will find out. In the middle, some clear. And also for the people that are using a thinner resin, you need to wait until the resin gets thicker. Otherwise, you will get mud and then the technique doesn't work. So you need to wait until it gets thicker, then you pour it, then you wait a little bit more longer before you pour the white on top, because that needs to be thicker than the colors you pour in first, and then you add the heat. But if you start directly after you mixed your resin, then it's too thin, then it doesn't work. Adding more of the grape jelly. Now I'm using my embossing tool to remove some air bubbles. And in the middle, I'm adding again a mixture of gold leaf, a super shard, pink silver glass glitter, and some holographic purple glitter. I think that will look nice. So no inks today, only the transparent tints from ColorArt, because I have a lot of colors from ColorArt and I wanted to try them out. And they are not shimmery, they are matte colors, so that's not a problem. And again, I'm not going to fill these coasters to the top, because then they are 1.5 centimeters. I think that's a little bit too thick, what I also mentioned in my previous videos. So I'm going to fill them to 1 centimeter. Then they are thick enough for me. More of the hot lips. And all the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites, as I always do. So all the transparent tints, but also the mold and the gold leaf, everything you can find in the description box. And also some promo codes. I have a promo code of a Resin Pro company, and if you order and you use my promo code Petra, then you get 10% discount, so that's great. And I am an affiliate of Jackson's Art Supply. So if you are a new customer there and you buy through my links, then you get on your first order 10% discount, so that's also great. But all the information you can find in the description box. Again, my embossing tool to remove some air bubbles. But I must say, in this resin are not a lot of air bubbles. And these coasters will be very colorful, but as you know, I love bright colors. And hopefully this will work out. I hope that the white, and this time I'm going to use the white paste from Resin Pro, will sink through the colors. For sure it will sink through the transparent parts, because it has no resistance of the color. But hopefully it will also sink a little bit through the colors. Adding more of the viola. And this technique is so much fun. And it's getting a little bit addictive, but yeah. This has very much possibilities in also in changing the design of the white line on top. So I'm going to experiment with that a little bit more. But I'm also going to experiment with mica pigments. I have a mica pigment line just paint. If you are interested in my mica pigments, then you can find all the information in the description box. They are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. So all the links to the Etsy shops are in the description box. But I also want to try my own mica pigments and to see if I can create some nice flowers with that. So I already started with the white circle line to create hopefully a nice flower. And what I already mentioned, I'm using the Resin Pro white paste. Yeah, and what I find out is that they are not available for the USA and Canada. I already spoke with my contact and they will try to make it available on Amazon so that you can also buy the Wave Pro powder pigment and the paste, because you can create some really nice effects with these pigments. Especially, I like especially the Wave Pro, because you can also use that white powder pigment in a ocean beach painting to make the waves. Yeah, now I'm adding heat on top of the white line in circles. To make the line a little bit wider. There you can see it. And I'm not using a torch, what I also mentioned in my previous video. If you use the torch and you hold it too long in one place, then you can damage your silicone mold. Then your coaster will get stuck. Yeah, and that's not what we want. And this embossing tool is not that hot as a torch or a heat gun. So that's why I'm using my embossing tool. I'm almost done with the coasters. Then I need to let this dry for 24 hours before I can take them out of the mold. So we are 24 hours later and I'm starting on the first coaster to take it out of the mold. That goes very easy. So no problems there. I also like this side of the coaster. Very nice. They are very shiny. The third one. I always I'm very careful taking them out. The last one. And then we will find out if the white is sank to the bottom. So I really like this side, but now the other side. Yes, it worked. And they look very nice. Yeah, these are very colorful. So now I know I can use also these transparent tints for the flower technique. So that's great. So at the end of this video, also a close-up. Then you can see it in the daylight. So if you're curious, then you can wait for that. But this worked. So I'm very pleased that my experiment was a success. A little bit closer, there you can see it. So this is the end result. I have them outside in the daylight. And I'm so pleased because the white looks great with all these colorful colors. And yeah, I'm liking it very much. Also the middle part with the gold leaf and the glass glitter. Very nice. I like these colors together. But my experiment worked. A little bit closer now. There you can see it. And the hot lips, the middle color, the pink color, is very bright. So nice. So if you like what I'm doing, consider to subscribe, what I already mentioned. Give me a thumbs up for this video, because that will help my channel a lot. All the information to the supplies I've used in this video, you can find at the end, but also in the description box. With all the links to the websites, also the links to my Facebook, Instagram, Etsy shop, influencers, Amazon store is in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!